Crashes to be employed when using a chat room or instant messaging.
Oh, okay. Well, instant messaging and chat rooms aren't very safe, but you should only talk to people, if you go on those, you should only talk to people you know, because you never know, if you talk to strangers, you never know who you're talking to, because they can say they're a 14-year-old girl, but they could really be a 50-year-old man eating potato chips in front of his computer.
If, like, someone you don't know, like, messages you, you should probably just leave the chat room.
And ignore it.
Yeah. Precautions to be employed when using a website about yourself or your school. When you're building a website about yourself, you should not give out any personal information.
Like your last name?
Yeah.
Because your last name, if you have your first and last name or your just your full name with your middle name, it's very easy for someone to track you down, especially when it involves your school, because not many people have the exact same name who go to your school.
Precautions to be employed when using email. When you use email, you should only accept and send out emails to people that you know, and if someone that you don't know emails you, you should delete it.
Yeah, good idea. I mean, if in your email, you should have like initials or just don't put your last name in it. You can just make up a name, like just a random name that doesn't really have too much significance. And if you for your password, you should mix numbers and letters, because it's harder for people to hack your emails and stuff.
Precautions to be employed if you encounter a website with risky images. You should, if you encounter like a website like that, you should probably just exit out, because there might be other stuff like mixed in with that, and you don't really want to look at those things, so you should really just leave.
And a lot of times you know what you're going to see on certain websites, so you shouldn't go on those websites in general, because you can get in a lot of trouble with those types of things. It's just not appropriate, so, yeah.
Precautions to be employed if a person you meet online asks for your photo. Well, if you go on a website where you're meeting people, you probably shouldn't be there in the first place. And if you are mixed up in that situation, then you should just say no and leave the website if someone asks for your photo, because that's really creepy.
Yeah, your photo, it's just unnecessary and just gross. No, that's just not appropriate. I mean, stay clear of those websites. I mean, you don't need to be on those. That's a no-no.
Precautions to be employed if a person you meet online starts an inappropriate conversation online. Again, you probably shouldn't be on that website in the first place. And if you are mixed up in that situation, then if they start an inappropriate conversation, again, you should just leave.
Or you should, if it gets into a really bad situation, but you shouldn't keep pressing the conversation if something like this is mentioned, you should just tell a parent or an adult, just someone who's there, because it's not safe for you to do this, because they could easily track you and everything, so.
Precautions to be employed if a person you meet online offers to send you inappropriate images. Again, you shouldn't be meeting people online, and if you do and they offer to send you inappropriate images, you should
say no.
Yeah, say no and leave and never go back to that website ever again.
You can get in trouble for images like that, because in Missing, Zach was confronted by his dad and then he ran away because of the pictures, the half-naked girl pictures.
He was kidnapped and smuggled across the border, and it was just
not a good situation to be in.
Precautions to be employed if a person you meet online asks to meet in person. Well, again, you should not be on these websites where you meet people that you don't know. You shouldn't be talking to anyone online that you don't know. And if they ask to meet you in person, that's bad, because they could be someone else that they say they aren't. And, like, they could kidnap you or murder you, or something really terrible could happen.
It's easy for people to just make up a fake screen name and a fake personality, so they could easily just be someone they're not. So don't meet people. And if it's something like Craigslist, where you're supposed to go to meet up to buy like whatever they're selling, you should take, if you're a kid, take a parent. You need to have more than one person come with you because you should never be alone in that situation. And yeah. So make sure you have an adult with you if you ever did that. But try and stay clear of those types of things unless it's okayed by your parents.
Yep.